Last week, in part one of a three-part series, we discussed the first thing all athletes and coaches need to do in their training to run faster, to actually sprint. Today, in part two, we're going to get into the second factor, improving muscular strength. It's time to get stronger and faster. Welcome to the Soccer Fitness video blog. Hello, I'm Richard Bucciarelli. This video is brought to you by Soccer Fitness and Speed Training. Please remember to like the video, comment on it, share it, and if you haven't already done so, subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell to make sure you never miss an update. Now here we go. In one word, the evidence in support of doing regular strength training to run faster is overwhelming. The fastest athletes in virtually every sport, including soccer, are also the strongest. To give just one example, a recent study out of Christiania University College in Norway found that world-class sprinters, on average, had strength-to-body-weight ratios, measured using the back squat exercise, up to 2 times higher than average people, and even over 1 time higher than those of other athletes. And stronger athletes aren't just faster, they're also more likely to reach the higher levels of competition in their sport. In soccer, this is especially true, as was demonstrated in another recent study out of the University of Aristotle in Thessaloniki in Greece, which showed that soccer players at the highest professional levels are stronger, they had a higher 1 repetition maximum squat, faster, they ran faster over short distance sprints, and more powerful, they had a higher 1 repetition maximum hang clean than those at lower competitive levels. There's a link to both of these studies in the video description below. So why is it that strength, especially lower body strength, is so important for improving running speed? We can think of the basic formula for running speed as being the product of stride length times stride frequency. Improving stride length is directly related to the amount of force that can be generated or pushed into the ground, and improving stride frequency has to do with getting the legs to move quicker. More on that one in our next video. Simply put, if you get stronger, you can produce more forces into the ground, and if you can produce higher forces into the ground, you can propel yourself forwards at greater distances when running, and that is why stronger legs make faster runners. Okay, so we've seen that there's a clear link between leg strength and running speed. So what is the best way for athletes to train in order to improve leg strength? As is usually the case with any type of speed training, it isn't complicated, it just involves a lot of hard work. With that said, here are our suggestions for the best 3 exercises to improve running speed by making your legs stronger, and how to perform them. To pick up the bar, lower it to a height at which you can stand under it with slightly bent knees and place the bar on top of the trapezius muscle on the back of the neck. Create a shelf by pulling the shoulder blades towards each other and lifting the elbows up slightly so they point slightly backwards. The bar can be positioned either higher up on the neck, more towards the head, or lower down on the neck, closer to the shoulders, depending on comfort level. Lift the bar up by pushing into the ground, then slowly step backwards out of the range of the rack or cage supports. Stand with feet slightly wider than hip width and the toes pointing straight forwards or slightly rotated outwards, depending on comfort level. To initiate the squat, move the hips slightly backwards, sticking the buttocks out while keeping the spine straight and neutral and the chest held up. Maintaining a neutral spine, slowly lower the body and weight downwards until the hips drop just below the knees. Then push hard into the ground through the feet, knees, and hips until returning to the starting position with straight and extended knees and hips. To set up the lift, place the barbell with weights loaded on the floor and stand over it with the bar as close to touching the shins as possible.
Bend at the hips and at the knees so that the spine is held neutral and parallel to the ground and the buttocks are pushed outwards. Grab the bar with an alternated grip, one hand with the palm facing outwards and the other with the palm facing inwards, and the shoulder blades pulled inwards towards each other. To initiate the lift, maintain a neutral spine and, holding the bar, push hard into the ground through the feet, knees, and hips until the knees and hips are extended and the bar is held off the ground below the hips. Next, slowly lower the weight back down to the ground by moving the hips backwards, keeping the spine straight and neutral, and bending at the knees only when the bar has passed just below the knees. The finished position should look exactly like the starting position, with the spine parallel to the floor. To set up the exercise, place a small plyometric box or bench behind the body, close enough that it can be reached by extending one leg backwards and touching it with the big toe of the foot, while maintaining the other foot firmly planted on the ground in front. Holding a dumbbell in one arm and keeping the spine held straight and neutral, stand in a split stance with feet hip-width apart and the opposite foot in front, staggered so that the body is as balanced as possible. Lower the weight by bending at the hip and knee while slightly leaning the torso forwards until the knee is close to a 90-degree angle. Then, push hard against the ground through the front foot until the knee and hip are extended and the body returns to the starting position. Perform an equal number of repetitions with both legs in front.
These three exercises are optimal because they use knee dominant in the back squat, hip dominant in the deadlift, and single leg in the split squat movements to target the legs in all of the most effective ways to build strength and increase stride length when running and sprinting. Here's an example of a simple training routine to follow using these three exercises. And remember, you don't need to do anything fancy to increase leg strength. You just need to put in consistent workouts and allow time for rest and recovery in between those workouts to get results. It's also advisable to lift weights with a partner or a spotter in order to ensure safety and proper lifting form throughout the workout. Perform the workout 2 days per week with a minimum of 48 hours of rest in between each day. Warm up for 5 to 10 minutes with running, dynamic stretches, and some mobility exercises for the entire body. For more on mobility training, check out our previous video here and in the video description below. Back squat, 3 sets of 8 repetitions with the maximum weight you can lift comfortably 8 times with 2.5 minutes rest between each set. Deadlift, 3 sets of 6 repetitions with the maximum weight you can lift comfortably 6 times with 2.5 to 3 minutes rest between each set. And split squat, 3 sets of 10 repetitions with the maximum weight you can lift comfortably 10 times with 2 minutes rest between each set. Thank you very much for watching this video and I hope you enjoyed it. Please remember to like and share the video, leave a comment to let us know what you thought about the topic, and hit the notification bell to make sure you never miss an update. We'll see you next time on the blog, and until then, keep reaching your soccer fitness goals.